Today we're going to be focusing on state standards BN4, which is proving theorems of triangles and solving problems to solve for the geometric figures. So by the end of the day today, you're going to be able to solve for missing angles within a triangle. Okay. So first off, what do you know about a triangle? What are some characteristics of a triangle?
Three sides.
Three angles. Okay, and what else? Okay, you're ahead of me. It equals to 180. What equals to 180? The inside of it. Okay. All right, and we're missing the vertices, these corners. Okay, so we're going to label them X, Y, and Z. Okay. So our classmate already let us know that the inside of triangle equals to 180. So does anyone know why it equals to 180? So this is a geometric proof that we can use when someone asks you, well, why does a triangle equal to 180? So if we have a triangle here, and then I cut this vertices, this top right here, then we get this shape, right? We get this right here. We get this. And what do we know about these corners?
They're 90 degrees
each. So 90 plus 90. Is 180, okay? So then when I extend this whole thing, it becomes a line. And through a protractor and through our mathematical knowledge, we know that a line equals to 180, correct? So that is how we can prove to someone that asks you how you know a triangle equals to 180. Because if you undo it, it becomes a line, okay? So, now knowing this, having this knowledge, we're going to go to example one on our sheets, and we're going to begin. So, it says the side of the triangle below has been extended. So, it's a triangle here. We're going to label our triangle X, Y, and Z. And it has been extended to form an exterior angle of 160. So now we know, now we have this new term, exterior angle. From our English language, we know that exterior means outside. So we know that this angle outside of the triangle is 180. And inside, if there's an exterior, there must be an interior. So here, we have an interior angle. And if we were to ignore this whole thing right here and just focus on this, what do we see? Let's ignore the triangle. Just from here to here. Oh, let me square it for you guys. Just this right here. What do we see?
A straight line.
And from our proof, a straight line equals to what?
180.
So this is a formula we're going to need. The interior angle of a triangle plus the exterior angle of a triangle equals to 180. And I forgot to mention over here that the angle X plus the angle Y plus the angle Z equals to 180. We already had it, we just didn't write the formula. And this is called the triangle sum theorem, okay? Okay, so this is what we use to solve for the angles inside the triangle, and that's what we use to solve for exterior and interior angles. Okay. So, if we continue reading, it says that the side of the triangle below has been extended to form an exterior angle of 160, and it wants us to find this angle right here. This is what we're looking for, okay? So before we get to that step, what can we do to solve for this? What would be our first step?
Find out what the other angle is?
Yes, finding out what this angle is, so then we can total it, okay? So if we apply this formula, our interior angle is our unknown. So we're gonna write interior angle. plus our exterior angle, what does that equal? Our exterior angle?
160.
Two angles, and we want to solve for the third angle. What can we do?
Add.
Okay, add and equal it to what?
73.
To what? 73. Okay. Is 73 the answer? Is that what you're saying? Okay. So before that, we're going to use that triangle sum theorem, okay? Because we have three angles in here, and we want to solve for one of them, okay? So if we were to use our triangle sum, that equal to 180, right? Our x is our unknown. What is our y degree equals? 20 degrees. Our z is 53. And our total of the triangle is 180. So if we add these, we get 73 degrees. So our next step here to get this would be to subtract 73. So we have solved that our x is equal to, is it 107?
Yep.
Yes, okay. So our angle here is equal to 107 degrees. And that's what the question was asking. Does anyone have any questions on how I solve that? Okay. No questions? If I'm in your way and you can't see, you can just let me know. Alright, so we're then going to go to our second problem on there. Interior is what's unknown. That's our dash 79 degrees. What you do on one side, you do to the next. So x is equal to what? 101. Okay. All right, so you see that that was a little bit shorter instead of using this one, because this is only asking for exterior and interior angles. Okay. So we're gonna go ahead and try this one. This is gonna be a new try. Does anyone need more time to write the top one? Are you okay? So go ahead and try this one. I'm gonna give you 3 minutes. I'll be walking around. If you have any further questions, but go ahead and try this, and then we'll come up here and solve it, okay? Always want to be coordinated. So for example, if this is I noticed a lot of us, we were getting confused on when to use what formula. So I want to reiterate that when we use this formula is when we're talking about the boundaries within a triangle, okay? So whenever we're talking about angles in here, and we use this one where we're talking about something that looks like a line, okay? It can be attached to a triangle, but it's always gonna be that portion, okay? So for example here, we would use that formula if we were being asked for this right here. So if we wanna solve for this x, which formula are we gonna start off with? All right, let's do this. So if we want to solve for this, right? This right here. By a raise of hands, how many of you would use the first formula? How many of you would use the second formula? Okay, so I see more of a second formula. Why would you use the second formula? The second formula. Okay, because it's a line. So this is the one you guys voted to. So you guys would use this. So what would be your next step?
149.
Okay. Oh, the other way around. Okay, so that's what you guys would do, right? Now what would that give you? Your interior angle would be what? What is it?
31.
Okay. 31. And you can totally do that. That's correct. But there's an easier way. The problem's asking you, well, no, it wouldn't be the easier way because you still need that. You need this, right? So from there, you just plug into that formula, the second one, right? Since we're solving for the inside of a triangle, we already have this form, this degree, which is 31. So now we're gonna use that second formula. Is everyone okay with that? Okay. Okay. So then here, we would plug in for x, just x by itself. What would we plug in for y?
31.
And our z?
90.
90, okay. Let me stand over here so I can get people on this side. And if we add these.
121.
Does everyone agree?
Yes.
Okay. And what would we do after that?
Subtract 121.
X equals to what?
59.
59, okay. So then for this problem, we had to use both of those formulas. So our X here equals to 59. And then if we wanted to check this problem, we would just add them again and make sure that they total up to 180. Okay, does anyone have any questions? Okay. So on your sheets, there's this formula, right? Or this image at the top. Okay. When I saw this at first, it was kind of confusing for me, but it's very helpful if you're able to understand it. So this is basically telling you that when you have these two pieces of information, two angles that is not exterior or interior, those are equal to the exterior angle. And we can see it with this example. Our A and B in here would be these. Okay. So two angles that is not interior are these, correct? Everyone sees that? Okay, so here we figure that 102 plus 53, those are, let me just redraw it for you guys so we can see that. Another way that you can add them to each other, what would that give us?
180.
Not 180.
Wait, I have a question.
Yes.
Where'd you get the 102 from?
We're taking in reference this example.
But then I thought it was 107.
Oh, I'm sorry. My 2 looks like a, or my 7 looks like a 2. Thank you, hon. 107. Okay. So if we were to add that, what would that equal? 160.
Yeah.
Okay. And what is the measurement of our exterior angle here? 160. So this is just something to keep in mind that can make your life easier when you have these two pieces of information. If you were to add that, it would give you this. Okay? Any questions on that? It is a bit confusing. Question? Okay. So I am done with the first fragment of our lesson. Any questions at all? So we're gonna go ahead and do